Hey, welcome back to the channel, Divine Timing, We Are Rising. I am your messenger, Shira, and I am back with another divinely guided, intuitive channel message just for you, collective. So remember to take what resonates and absolutely leave the rest. Okay, this is going to be an all signs channeled reading. Okay. I'm not really channeling much as of yet. I'm just kind of, like I said, in my previous readings, I do like to keep my window open. So right now I just kind of hear like a child screaming. So this can be in symbiosis to how someone is feeling inside. Maybe their inner child is screaming out to them, spirit is saying. Alrighty, I hope you all are having a very happy, healthy, wealthy, and prosperous Sunday. I hope you all are remaining your good and remaining and maintaining your good energy and sticking with it and not allowing the adversary or any type of negative energy penetrate. By the way, if you are new here and if you just randomly came across this video, I would greatly appreciate it if you could go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe, especially if the reading or any of my readings, perhaps, go ahead and check them out when you get the time to. But if any of my readings resonate with you, please don't hesitate to like and comment, okay? And definitely subscribe. I really appreciate the support. I'm definitely, on the back end, just planning a lot of great things. You see, there's this Four of Knives energy in the middle of the deck. So someone is in real deep planning and preparation mode. Really going within themselves to bring about something new, some sort of creative endeavor, spirit is saying. So take it where it resonates. Okay, Most High Creator of all things, ancestors, spirit guides, divine intelligence, please come aboard and assist me with this beautiful reading for our beautiful divine collective. By the way, just in advance, if one of my children come out of the room, and I wouldn't say intercept because they're children after all, you know, their needs come first. However, they do understand that I am working and, you know, I don't mind them coming in, especially if they have, you know, a need of some sort. So I hope you all don't mind. All right, I just wanted to make sure I did a good shuffle just to ensure we pull the proper energy. And by the way, I have like some marker Sharpie on my fingernail, so if you see that, I hope it doesn't distract you too much. All right, we have Seven of Knives in the upright position. I'm definitely getting a tug and pull and picking up on the energy of someone in your energetic field putting on a fake mask, withholding a fake image, pretending to like you when they really don't. We have Nine of Sticks. I'm definitely getting a pull on some very protective energy here from divine source of all things. I feel like you are now being revealed. Those of whom aren't really for you, a lot of their underhanded comments or demeaning comments and such, you kind of really have taken heed to, and you have been able to handle these said individuals accordingly. And as such, we just pulled the Eight of Knives. I see you taking and embarking on a new mission, a new journey. A lot of you are in this period of solitude. You may be experiencing a period of loneliness or just isolation, spirit is saying. And it's because of you having overcome everything that had been set against you and put in your path to disrupt you and distract you and ultimately set you apart from your soul's mission and your soul's journey, spirit is saying. So it's just imperative to beware of these people in your energetic field wearing false masks and pretending to be someone that they are not, Spirit is saying. You do have divine protection around you, though. You do have divine insight during this time. Many of you could be receiving a lot of divine downloads from the Most High God of all things himself. Mother Earth can be speaking to you, divine feminine, and divinely guiding you throughout your journey of further awakening and consciousness, as you undergo deeper forms of consciousness, Spirit is saying. All right. We have Ten of Knives. So I definitely feel an energy of old habits, old ways, old behaviors attempting to try to creep back in. You see? And get back into the auric field, get back into your energetic field, and pull you back to what you once knew, right? Okay, we have the Magician on the bottom of the deck. So yeah, you are definitely really co-creating your reality with the Most High God of all things during this time. You are really, really being divinely led and guided by Spirit. Nonetheless, even with all of these attacks that you are withstanding and enduring, even in your lonesome, you know, you're still getting through it. And somehow, some way, the Most High God is still sending blessings and abundance and prosperity your way, because you are, like I said, you are enduring. You're withstanding the test of time. Okay? Let's further clarify the message. Spirit guides, Most High. All right, yep. There's some jealousy in the air, which is why we pulled this Seven of Knives energy. Someone is definitely putting on a false mask, pretending as if they really care for you, or as if they really have some sort of love for you, when deep down inside they really don't. You know, they really wish for your downfall. They really hope for your downfall, Spirit is saying. And it's time to use your voice. Spirit is saying, do not fear anything. Do not fear speaking up and speaking your truth and using your voice. This is all a part of your healing process, Spirit is saying. You know, I'm definitely, like I said, I'm definitely picking up on this Magician energy.
Last time, B word.
Nariah, are you saying the B word? Okay,
yeah.
Well, I'm working. Can you guys please give it a second?
Here.
Okay, go turn the laptop on, and then I'll turn the Wi-Fi on. Okay. Go get the laptop on, Nalani, please.
Mom,
I will get it on. Just turn it on, please.
Mom,
Lonnie, get in here. Okay, go, Lonnie, or you will not be going to the park today if you're not going to be able to listen. Nalani. Sorry, guys. But yeah, you are the Magician. You are the co-creator of your life during this time. You are the co-creator of this season. You know, you are working alongside of the Most High itself, divine source of all things itself. You know? Yes, baby. Can you please go in the room so we can go to the park? Here, go put your lip gloss on, okay? But you have to put it on in the room. Okay, close the door, please. I'll come in there and get my laptop on in a minute. Oh, Lordy. But, yeah, you are the Magician, Spirit is saying. Let's further, that's a lot of messages. Thank you, Spirit. But can we get some more that really aligns with this reading thus far, Spirit? Can we get a couple more, though? It's not so many, unless you prefer us to have many. Spirit guides, Most High Creator of all things, ancestors. All right. Okay, that does. That'll work. Okay. You are locked in spiritually. You know, and that's what a lot of these individuals do not realize. Those of whom are appearing and showing up in your energetic field, they don't realize that you are locked in spiritually. So you can see through their hidden motives. You can see through the hidden attacks that they have set upon your path. You can see through it. And they are very, very threatened by this. And so they'll claim that you are this or you are that. You're being demonic. You're being devilish. You're this or that. But they don't realize that this is spirit working through you. This is the Most High itself working through you. Divine source of all things. Mother Earth working through you. Speaking through you. These are your spirit guides, your ancestors, those who have came before you. That ancient knowledge, Spirit is saying. A lot of you have tapped into to your Akashic records. And these people, they don't even know how to spell Akashic records, Spirit is saying. They don't even know how to even perceive that. They don't even know what that means, Spirit is saying. Someone here could be dealing with addictions. Whether this is you, Divine Feminine, and or the Divine Masculine, I want you all to know that, you know, yes, I do feel an energy that you all are going through a lot. I feel like there's a lot of different changes taking place currently in your life. But I also want you to know that it is ultimately up to you. You know, you, Spirit is saying you can't take these addictions into your next level because you are slowly but surely progressing into your next level, you know, and it's coming rapidly. You know, you are manifesting this rapidly, okay, in your alone time, in your lonesome, you know, fighting these demons, fighting these different principalities, ignoring and rejecting these different energies and so-called friends, but really are foes. You know, you're just rejecting all of what once was to get to your greater good, to get to your grand rising, to get to what God has bestowed upon you. You know, and it's no hate, Spirit is saying. It's no hate. But yeah, like don't lie upon on these addictions. 1222 is just on the clock. You know, Spirit is saying, lean on me. Don't feel too good when the shoe is on the other foot. Yep. Someone in your energetic field is pissed off because of the fact that you are speaking and living in your truth. And a part of your truth exposes the demons that lie within them. And it doesn't feel too good when the shoe is on the other foot. Meanwhile, it's not you slandering them. It's not you feeling as though you are better or that you are above or superior to them. It's just the fact that you were speaking the truth as it is, as it was. You know, and these people for so long, Spirit is saying, have carried on this facade, this illusion to the outside world, perceiving you to be a certain way when all along you weren't. The same way they were projecting what was really within them on you was really within them. They were the ones wearing the false mask. They were the one projecting their insecurities, their jealousy, their envy, and all of their demons onto you and making you out to be who it was that they really are. You know, but it don't feel too good when the shoe is on the other foot, when you begin speaking and living in your truth, and when you reject them and deny access to them. You know, it doesn't feel too good. This is a little boy stuck in a grown man's body. Someone who can't seem to grow up. Someone who can't seem to enlighten themselves, to grow and to advance. Emotionally, first and foremost, this is a very emotionally disturbed individual who, because of what they went through in their past, Spirit is saying, in their childhoods or in their lives, period, as a whole, this person has remained trapped in the age and in those developments in which all of this occurred. This person is still a little ass boy, a scared ass little ass boy, trapped in a grown man's body. Take it where it resonates, collective. Divine Masculine has hidden gifts, talents, and abilities. Yes, the Divine Masculine is certainly in his Black Hermit energy. The divine masculine, excuse me, the divine masculine is realizing that he is the magician. You know, he is godlike. He is made in the image of God. You know, he is Christ-like. You know, he is the divine masculine. He is strong-willed. He is not what others have told him that he was. He is not what his experiences have been. And so you have realized the same, divine feminine. How open-minded are you? Spirit is asking. How open-minded are you? How open-minded are you to the truth that lies within yourself? How open-minded are you to the truth that is hidden in plain sight around you? Are you open and receptive to accepting the truth? Spirit is saying. They feel as if you betrayed them before. Ticket word resonates, but I'm definitely picking up on a divine masculine energy who feels as though somewhere, whether here and now or in the past, you have betrayed them in some way. So we're going to definitely clarify that. But let's get on with the further messages we've received thus far, though. The love we once had is beneath me now. Yeah, so this could certainly be in regards to this karmic energy who is exuding this jealousy in the air and who is trying their damnedest to prevent you from using your voice and who could be dealing with some sort of addiction. It could be a drug addiction, alcohol addiction, a sexual addiction, some sort of addiction. They could be addicted to social media, addicted to... You could be addicted to anything. So take it where it resonates. I'm definitely and strongly pulling up on just a strong addiction of some sort. Okay. I love you. Someone definitely loves you. Even though Spirit is saying that they have felt confused and a bit befuddled. They didn't know if the love that they had felt was really true. They didn't know how to accept it. They didn't know how to perceive it, you know, and or they didn't really know how to perceive it, honestly. So yeah, you got them feeling some kind of way. This can pertain to both the divine masculine energy and or this karmic masculine energy. You got them feeling some type of way ever since you began using your voice. And you using your voice is what I'm hearing has ignited and has awakened some sort of curiosity within the divine masculine.
Mommy, eat my makeup.
That's pretty, baby. Go finish it and then show me when you're done, okay?
When it's done.
Okay, well, mommy's finishing work, all right? And then as soon as I'm done, we'll play makeup. But no, you can't get in the video. But yeah, you definitely got them feeling some kind of way.
Yeah, you did it better. That's me.
Okay, go do your video in the room on the laptop. Go turn around and turn the camera on the laptop. Please. Okay. Thank you. Okay. One moment, though.
I don't know how.
Okay, we'll figure it out. Close the door, please.
What if I get password? That's how you go.
I'll do that in a second. Nalani, you have to go in there so mommy can finish working, okay? Or if you're going to be in here, you have to be quiet for just a second, okay?
Hi.
No, you can't get into the video, Lonnie.
I say hi.
Okay, but now go sit down. You said hi. Now go sit down, please. Sorry, guys.
I want to be out here with you and be quiet.
Okay, go sit down.
Okay.
But yeah, like you definitely got them feeling some kind of way. All right, so Spirit guides, Most High, Creator of all things, let's clarify this. They feel as if you betrayed them before. Why do they feel that way? Okay. You could feel placed on a back burner, or they could feel as if you placed them on a back burner. Okay. the one who got away. Spirit is saying, you will always be the one who got away. The one who escaped the madness. The one who escaped the rat race. The one who escaped the loop. The one who escaped the illusion. Spirit is saying that you are the one who got away. My daughter's coughing in the background, you guys. She's so funny. Go sit down, please. I deserve the best, remember? Yeah. You could be telling this to your divine masculine. Like, you're like, look, I deserve the best, remember? They could have told you at one point, like, you know, you deserve the best. But Spirit is also saying that they felt like the best that they know that you deserve is something that they couldn't give you at the time. But now they are open to it, you know? Yeah. And they're constantly thinking about the times you had, you know, the times the two of you had. Okay. My everything. You could feel as though they're your everything in terms of, you know, romance. You know, you just feel like they're the best you ever had. No one else can compare to this love that you have felt and that they have ignited within you, and that you have very well did the same through them, but it's just very hard for them to grasp and very hard for them, you know, to understand, because they've been surrounded by false images, fake identities, and masks all of their lives, and so have you. And now you all are evolving and, you know, just really growing and deprogramming from all of that, Spirit is saying. But they're chasing you heavy in the spiritual. So you can notice during this time, you can be having a lot of dreams about this person. You can be thinking about this person heavily, even when you try to reject it. Even when you don't want to think about this person, you can be thinking about them heavily. And they are feeling the same way. Okay? Uh-oh. Going against the odds. Yeah, so you are definitely going against the odds in whatever endeavors you are partaking in. You are going against the odds. You are very relentless. You are very soul-driven, very purpose-driven. And nothing or no one can stop you. 2222 is just on the clock. Hello. Holding on for dear life. This could be the connection between both you and the divine masculine. This could be how they are feeling towards you. But I'm also picking up that this could be the karmic masculine energy. You know, they are attempting to do all that they can to hold on to your energy because, you know, you were their life force. You was the glue that held it all together. And no one can compare to you. And even they realize that. But you honestly don't want anything to do with this person. And they can't seem to understand that. You have moved on in love and in grace and in gratitude for having learned the lesson, the karmic lesson, and having survived it, right? And this person can't seem to do the same, Spirit is saying. All right? Haters watching from afar. Hey, listen, you guys. I'm working. Haters watching from afar. Definitely. There could be a lot and many haters watching from afar during this time. But Spirit is saying there's really nothing you have to worry about. You know, you just keep going. You keep doing, you keep doing what you have been divinely guided and intuitively guided to do. You know, in terms of your wish fulfilled. Get back. I didn't see you in the video, please. Okay, in terms of your wish fulfillment and things like that. All right, but yeah, you have a lot of haters watching from afar, though. Hey, calm down, Milani. I'm trying to finish, baby. I'm almost done. I got to get this message out to the Divine Collective.
Mom, yeah.
Okay?
That's bad. It has to go.
Okay, well, sit down so we can get this message out, all right?
Yes,
the Divine Collective wants to get their message finished.
Yeah.
Okay, no, don't get in my video, please. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Go sit down.
Yeah.
Okay, go sit down.
Mommy.
Yeah, someone's coming in with all the cuteness. Definitely, Spirit is saying. Yeah. Two of Cups. Reunion. Celebration, union, reunification, Coming out of separation, Spirit is saying. Definitely picking up on twin flame energy. Okay, we have the Queen of Swords here. You're very resourceful. You're very impactful. You're very inspiring. You're very enlightening. You're very intuitive. You pack a great punch, Spirit is saying. You can endure, you know. Okay. We have the Magician in the reverse. So we have the Magician twice. Wow, the Magician clarifying the Magician. Ain't that something? But we have the Magician in the reverse here. And then we have the Magician in the upright position here. So I'm definitely picking up on an energy that whatever someone is trying to send your way in terms of trying to tarnish something that you have going for yourself or taint something that you have going for yourself, Spirit is saying that they are being blocked heavily. You know, they are being creatively blocked, emotionally blocked, mentally blocked, you know, for trying to cause bad and trying to cause a tower moment in your life. Okay. Then we have the Seven of Wands. Someone is working very, very hard and strategically at something. Someone is working very hard behind the scenes, and Spirit is wanting me to divinely guide you all and to let you all know to keep working hard behind the scenes, whatever it is that you wish to bring into fruition and whatever it is that you wish to manifest that is going to be for your greater good and for the highest good of all ultimately, then the Most High is saying to really, really keep working diligently, but keep it under wraps. You know, don't tell everybody your goals, don't tell everybody your wishes, don't tell everybody what it is that you are working on, Spirit is saying. Because everybody doesn't want to see you win. Everyone doesn't want to see you make it. Everyone doesn't want to see you rise from the pit that they thought you were going to be trapped in forever. Okay? What's that?
It's the fruit snack box.
Okay, that's cute. Milani, go draw the fruit snack box. Oh, go do the shape. I think that's a triangle. Yep, that's a triangle.
Why don't you open this?
Okay, I'll open it. Alrighty, go sit down, baby. All right, so we're going to get this message clarified. I'm going to pull just a couple of the Doreen Virtue Romance Novels Oracle deck. I'm actually getting a new Oracle deck tomorrow, you guys. I'm really, really excited. I'm super excited. If I say one more time, like I'm going to swear like I'm going to turn into a blonde or something. No shades of blondes. I love all of you. I love everybody. But yeah, I want to definitely clarify this divine masculine has hidden gifts, talents, and abilities. That's funny that that came up twice in the same weekend energetically. Like I said, this divine masculine is like, I'm blocking everything that you send in my divine feminine's way. I'm blocking everything that you're sending my way. Like, you're being blocked. So yeah. All right. Give your relationship a chance. Work on your partnership. Absolutely. So this is a message from Spirit. Definitely give your relationship a chance. Work on your partnership. You know, work on getting to know each other. You know, work on starting over. You know, it is never too late to start over, Spirit is saying. Give it a chance. All right. Keep working. Unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. Take it where it resonates, but I'm just definitely feeling like what it is that it's just not enough faith. It's not enough willpower on someone's end. I'm definitely feeling like it's this divine masculine energy here. Yeah, it's this karmic energy. There's not enough love, attraction, or chemistry to keep the relationship going. You know, what's done is done, Spirit is saying. Yes, baby. Okay, that's pretty. That's pizza. Or that's...
It's pizza.
Yeah, it's pizza. Okay. One more message, Spirit. One more message. Thank you. Alrighty, you all. So we have deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. As I said, Seven of Knives energy. Someone is definitely wearing a false mask and embodying this deceptive energy, this deceptive and false imagery, kind of like, I can't really describe it in its entirety, but what I can tell you all to kind of say it in layman's terms, it's like this person's trying, I feel like spirit's saying this person's trying to steal your identity. They're trying to pretend as if they are you, but it's like, see that fake ass smile they have on their face? It's like not even gonna work. Close your ears, kids, but it's like not even going to work. Like, seriously, it's not even gonna work, you know? And spirit is just telling you to be aware of that, okay? But that's what I have. So I hope you all enjoyed the message. And if you did, please do not hesitate to give it a thumbs up. Like, share, subscribe if you aren't already. And definitely comment if it resonates. I definitely appreciate the support. I love engaging with you all and receiving your comments. And hit that description box and definitely follow me on my social medias, my Twitter and my Instagram. And definitely subscribe to my primary channel, Lovely Fly Shy. But yes, that was the reading. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And until next time, divine timing, we are rising. And I am checking out. Peace and love. Thank you.